Hola, bienvenidos a Estrategias de Inversión. Estamos con Paul Rogers, gestor de renta variable de la gestora Lazard Asset Management, para hablar de mercados emergentes y sobre todo de América Latina, aprovechando el foro Latibex, donde los gestores de fondos tienen un papel destacado y hay una conferencia que versa sobre ello. Muy buenos días, Paul, ¿qué tal?
Muy bien, gracias.
¿Cómo ve la situación de los mercados en América Latina?
Well, in 2017, we've had a very good year in most markets, with the exception of Mexico. Going forward, we look to see things looking relatively good, although the outcomes are not yet clear. There's a lot going on in the markets.
En el fondo Lazard Emerging Markets Core Equity tiene un 60% de exposición a compañías de Asia y un 15% a la región latinoamericana. En el mundo emergente, ¿les gusta más esta Asia que América Latina?
When we invest, we look specifically at companies. We want very concentrated portfolios. In our emerging markets core portfolio, there's only about 70 stocks. In the Latin American strategy that we run, which is not yet a fund, we have below 40 stocks. So we think more about the company opportunities rather than on a country by country basis. But we are overweight in our emerging markets core strategy slightly, with an emphasis on Brazil and Mexico.
Cuando compra acciones de un banco latinoamericano, ¿qué papel juega el riesgo divisa cuando el riesgo divisa?
Yeah. We think of banks in general as a good beta play on markets. So in most of our strategies, we generally have the largest and most liquid banks at the most attractive valuations. In Brazil, obviously, there's a lot of bank opportunities, so we might have two or three there, also in Mexico. But a lot depends on valuation, and we tend to not concern ourselves too much about the individual daily or monthly or weekly volatility and currency risk. We look for long-term holdings over a market cycle rather than near-term currency moves, etc.
¿Cree que es un buen momento para comprar compañías de materias primas y sobre todo ligadas al petróleo, aprovechando la subida que está teniendo?
We always like to buy the companies before they've moved up a lot, and we have some good examples of that in places like Colombia in the energy space, and in Peru in materials. Commodities has had a nice rally. We think that's very positive for companies in Latin America and the countries overall. It has risen quite aggressively now, and so we always like to look at the longer term. I do think that commodities and energy going forward is a very positive space. There are a lot of things in technology which are going to require commodities such as copper. So we do think that the trends in terms of rising prices in commodities, both the base metals, material space, and then also the rising prices in energy, are going to be very good over the longer term for Latin America.
Por países, en la región latinoamericana, los más importantes son Brasil y México para el fondo. Y en el 2018 se celebran elecciones en ambos países. ¿Les preocupa el avance del populismo como en Venezuela en estos dos países?
You always have to be concerned with the politics in the region. We saw this in Argentina, which has turned out quite favorably in terms of the elections there. We've seen populism around the world, but we also don't like to try to predict what's going to happen. We've very difficult to choose the elections. We are concerned more about Mexico, with the potential for López Obrador to get in there. That seems to be Mexico's in a more difficult spot right now. Brazil, it does seem as though Temer and his team are making the right changes, and this will be positive momentum for a more moderate candidate. But there is always the outside possibility that Lula might return, or another more populist candidate. So it definitely is a risk in Latin America. It's also a very large risk globally today.
Y ya por último, ¿cómo ve la situación de las filiales de Telefónica, BBVA y Santander que operan en América Latina?
Well, we do own Telefónica Brasil. We think it's doing quite well. You know, it's a strong player in Brazil with the other rest of the competition. The other banks we think are expensive. I think part of that is the premium being owned by a foreign bank and being very well managed. They are trading at a premium valuation, but I do think they're very well situated. In general, we think across emerging markets, we're in a recovery phase. That they had a very difficult, all companies, we saw declining returns on equity over the last 5 years, and now we're beginning to see a recovery. So we're seeing earnings pick up, we're seeing leverage come down, we're seeing non-performing loans improve in the banking sector. So we do hope and think that we are in a recovery and we're gonna see more earnings momentum, better asset quality coming through in 2018, and then ideally into 1920 and looking out over a 3 or 5 year time horizon.
Pues muchas gracias, Paul, por acompañarnos. Thank you very much for
coming. Thanks for having me.
Ustedes pueden seguir informados de toda la actualidad de la bolsa y los mercados en estrategiasdeinversión.com. Muchas gracias.